The Edelweiss staff will doubtless be eager to show off their facility to a fellow physician. I have already taken the liberty of sending a letter on your behalf to request a visit. And what of you? I shall be pursuing other avenues. Should you see anything troublesome or improper, simply notify the local authorities. Otherwise, try a little analysis yourself. You know my methods. Apply them.
Hello everyone, this is the Game and Pop here, and today I am back for part 3 of Sherlock Holmes, The Awakened. I was about to say chapter 1. So, last time we went down to the Port of London. We did some investigating there to find the kidnapper of Kimahia. But it has led us all the way to the Edelweiss Institute in Switzerland. So, this is where the demo actually began. But I'm not going to skip any of this. So, I hope everyone's doing well today. I'm happy to be back to this game. I think after this I'm going to record another episode as well of this game. Because I want to finish this game before the month ends. I would like to, because I got some other stuff planned next month. Let me do something for a moment. Okay, there we go. That might be better in terms of sound, hopefully.
I cannot wait to see her.
My daughter receives the finest treatment money can buy.
Yes, I remember. Examination room?
No visitors are allowed through here. Professor's orders.
Okay, then. No visitors allowed. Yep, I remember. We got here. A visitor from space. Glowing meteor lands in Arkham. Color out of space, I feel. A reference to color out of space. Let's talk to the front desk.
Salutations, madam. I am Dr. John Watson. I was wondering if you've got word of my visit.
Yeah, Dr. Watson. We received your letter on the matter. Would it be to see Professor Gygax?
Yes.
At their earliest convenience, yes. I shall try not to take up too much of their valuable time.
Wait here, bitte. Mr. and Mrs. Bronson, your girl has made remarkable progress. See? Take a look for yourself.
My apologies for keeping you waiting, Dr. Watson. Surely you understand how medical work can make one lose track of time.
Do not be sorry, Professor. I too know the importance of closely attending to patients.
The work hardly stops here, yet the satisfaction of perfecting the mind compels us to persevere.
I take it you welcome many a soul into your establishment?
Admissions, yes. Visitors, though? I am curious as to what brought you to the Schwarzes Edelweiss.
Word of mouth. An article I read back in London spoke highly of your institution. But rather than taking its word
I
would see things for my...
My asylum's reputation precedes it then.
Everyone, your attention, please. Guten Day. Yes. The name's Amos Colby, Northwood Detective Agency, Boston. I got questions that need answers. Who's in charge here?
Oh, that makes a lot more sense
now. What seems to be the matter, Dr. Watson? You can tell me.
By Jove, it cannot be him. right. Yes, I was surprised because that man is a celebrity. Yes, that's it. Very famous, Mr. Colby. I couldn't believe my eyes.
No. In my line of work, it can't wait. The longer it takes
if you
to get
wish
to the
recuperate,
truth,
Dr. Watson, you may avail yourself of the guest room.
But I have so much more to discuss.
Nurse, if you'd be so kind as to escort Dr. Watson to the guest room. Herr Colby, from Northwood Agency. How unexpected. I am Professor Gygax. I would be happy to answer your questions in the examination room.
Look, Professor, unless you got any clues as to the whereabouts of...
There is no need to be alarmed. No one gets infected in my
There are a lot of orderlies around me, around Sherlock. Oh, jeez.
Now, let's not resort to brute force.
Do not worry, Herr Colby. My methods are rather more delicate. Search him thoroughly. Then take him to the holding chamber. I need to decide precisely what to do with our guest.
Yep, here we are. You still have her disguise on.
The unmistakable scent of alcoholism. Did you walk through their doors as I did, or did they collect you off the streets?
Either one, that is very possible. Is there anything to look at in here? No. There wasn't in the demo, so. Let us see. Ah, yes. Lockpicking. Nope, wrong button. Wrong button, please. That. Yep. Let's see. Okay, so we got the last one. So that needs another. So the first one needs two. You need another. Is that right? No. So we got, okay, so the... There we go, just like that.
A truncheon, not the typical tool for a nurse.
No, not really. Let's see, what do we got in terms of cases? Investigating the Edelweiss, a simple case of a missing servant has become a full investigation into mass kidnappings. The Trail of Dirty Summers, that's what we had pinned. The Trail of Dirty Summers and the abductees leads to the Black Edelweiss Institute, which specializes in mental illnesses and addictions. Established in 1789 by Professor Keller, it is now headed by Professor Gygax. Watson's successful infiltration. Dr. Watson managed to get into the asylum and is staying in one of the rooms on the ground floor. He even tried to play along with the fake Amos Colby, but clearly performance is not his strong suit. And then Black Edelweiss secrets. Something macabre is going on in this asylum, and every little detail will help in understanding it. So yep, that's exactly where we are. You cannot change clothes here. Okay. Holding chamber. Block A. Scene investigation found. Oh. Found something. Oh. Examination room. I don't. Do I want to go to the examination room first? I don't know. Let's go up here first and examine everything.
Done. No way I can get past him without being noticed.
Yep. So we're not going that way.
There's the guest room. I wonder if Watson was able to speak to Gygax.
Possibly. Dr. Watson is in the guest room that is next door to Gygax's office.
Locked. I suppose the reception will be guarded anyway.
Yep. Most likely. The doors to the ground floor are locked and likely guarded. It appears that I cannot get back upstairs. Yep, there's nothing over here, but we do have stuff over here.
This sedative worked faster than I expected. Perhaps I ought to train myself. Build up a tolerance.
Wrong button. I keep hitting the wrong button. A powerful and fast-acting sedative. It could prove useful. Could very much prove useful.
I'd rather not sit in this chair ever again.
Yeah, we don't want to do that. Because that was not fun. Let's head on back downstairs. No, there's nothing in the cabinet. Okay, back on downstairs. Let's see. Apothecary. Hans Winkler. Okay. What do we got here? This is all repeating what we did
in
the demo.
Any chemist would envy the quality of this equipment.
But I don't mind repeating what we did in the demo.
The final product, ready to cure madness, or to push one deeper into its grasp. Raw materials used to formulate medicine. With this equipment, they can create any type of medication.
Yep. Which is not good. Got needles.
Very sturdy. I might borrow it.
Yeah, let's just take the needles. A couple of unused syringes were found in the apothecary room next to the asylum's laboratory. Fourth little frog. What is this? Frogs can't wash up, and I surely can. That is the difference between a frog and a man. Fourth little frog was dirty and rotten. What if I put that frog in the water? Lazy Dundrop swims in a bath. Laundry becomes the end of her path. Fourth little frog dies in the walls of Black Edelweiss.
That sounds sinister, even for a place like this. I wonder if there are more frogs in the pond.
What? The frogs in the walls. Okay, I don't think we can do that just yet, but sure. Block A patients, patient Eloise K, diagnosis. Dermatillomania, commentary, nail trimming every day, do not untie her hands even if she won't stop screaming. Maurizio H, mania, disassociation, after the incident with the nurses, prescribed therapeutic fasting for a week, mentioned Josephine to make him more manageable. Mariana W, hysteria, keep raising the dosage until she forgets the child, stupor is quite acceptable. Nils J, nervous breakdown, do not allow any visits, all letters sent to the patient must be destroyed. Okay, interesting. Frogs.
What was that? Is someone there?
Okay, obstructed access through to block B is obstructed by a guard. There must be a way to slip past him without being caught. Okay, yep, I remember that. We can't go that way. Lionel Reichart.
You there?
Ooh.
I command you to free me at once.
Oh yeah, you.
I'm not sure that's a great idea at the moment.
How dare you deny me? I must have my revenge against the Lickspittles upstairs.
Fortunately for you, I'm here to stop the very same people.
You are?
Indeed.
Yes.
But first, I must discover all I can about this institution. Tell me, have you witnessed the arrival of any foreign patients?
Tell me? The gall? The impertinence to bark such orders?
Please, we don't have time for this.
Do you know with whom you speak?
No.
I am the great Napoleon.
Napoleon Bonaparte?
The one and only. Emperor of the French, first consul of the Republic, leader of La Grande Armée. Once I am free and have exacted my revenge against the guards who ridicule me, I shall rest happy in the arms of my beloved Josephine.
Right. Well, I will leave you to your scheming, Emperor.
Patient hates the guards. There's a patient in Block A who believes he is Napoleon Bonaparte. He wants nothing more than to seek revenge against the guards upstairs who imprisoned him. After his retribution, he wants to return to France. Yep. I remember.
I command you to let me out!
Sorry, that's not gonna happen. Because you, sir, are insane. Raelian.
My heart is pierced by Cupid. I disdain all glittering gold. There is nothing can console me but my jolly sailor boat.
Felicia Hung. Storage room. Let's go in the storage room. Yes. I remember. We gotta do lockpicking. Oh, no. Let's see where we need to be. So, we're nowhere near where we need to be. Okay, we got the middle one. Need one more, two there, so two more there. One more there. How's that? Okay, we got those three. Now we just need that last one. There we go. Perfect. Okay, what do we got? Let's look at everything.
A certificate of appreciation from the municipal councillor to Professor Becker for contributions to the development of medicine in Interlaken.
Mm-hmm. We got nails. We're not looking at those.
A simple toolbox, yet capable of repairing anything.
I'm gonna take that off the screen because that's bothersome. Let's see. We got a letter. A note from Professor Becker. Professor Gygax, I have suffered serious chemical burns upon my hand, the consequence of your inexcusable actions. My session with Gerda ended before it even began. Poor thing was so terrified she refused to talk and started to destroy everything in the room rather than let me approach her. What you did to Gerda will not and cannot happen again. Let it be known that I consider your methods a barbaric malpractice. If, as you so boldly claim, you wish to be the future of my facility, you must embody my high standards. Do not disappoint me again. Professor Becker, Director of Black Edelweiss. Yep. The terrible barbaric methods. By which Gygax does her thing.
Tubes of varying diameters. Interesting.
Oh, what did we get? Metal tubes. Selection of metal tubes from the storage room with a range of different diameters. Yep. We got the dumbwaiter with various things in it.
This photo was damaged, seemingly by oil. I can make out the names listed here.
Yep.
Cooking grease. Is this the kitchen dumbwaiter?
Very much so. Which we also have the lever we can look at.
Looks like it's still operational.
Yep. A working dumbwaiter. The storage room has an unused dumbwaiter that still seems to be fully functional. Judging by the cooking grease stains, it is connected to the kitchen above. Tattered grainy photograph of the Black Edelweiss staff. On the back is a list of names: Dr. Feister, Dr. Huber, Professor Gygax, and Professor Becker.
Speech and the Cerebellum by S.A. Becker. Painting in a mental institution. Vogel would be delighted.
Yes, he would be. Fifth little frog. Oh, the fifth one. Frogs cannot kill, but I surely can. That is the difference between a frog and a man. Fifth little frog was foolish at large. He forgot about rules and who is in charge. Timothy Camilleri lies dead in Block B. I swapped out his pills for something nasty. Fifth little frog dies in the walls of Black Edelweiss. So we need to find the third, second, and first, because we have the fourth and the fifth.
John Sallow, the Tulpa phenomenon. I'm somewhat of an expert already.
Achievement unlocked. Fond memories. Okay, we got an achievement.
R.G. Hill, Dr. Connolly, It appears that all the psychiatric classics were banished here.
Anything else in the room that we can look at? It does not look like it. Okay. Let us see what we can do. How to safely remove the Block B guard. Yep. Okay, so, oh, well. Syringes, bottle, sedative, and then the metal tubes. Yeah. Use a handmade blowpipe with a sedative. It could be possible to sedate the guard from a distance using a handmade blowpipe. Perhaps one of the tubes from the storage room could suit. Yep. Oh. Game's taking a moment. Okay, let's take one of the metal tubes.
This should suffice.
Yep. The blowpipe is now ready to use. Yes, it is.
My comrades in Paris shall hear about this.
Good to know. Good to know. Okay, let's put this person, let's put him down. There we go. Time to go to sleep. And just like that. Oh, we got something right here. First little frog. Frogs cannot think, and I surely can. That is a difference between a frog and a man. First little frog was my very first try. Her dumb little head is needed to pry. Hannah Pollard near the hole in the wall wanders. There, her head with a brick encounters. First little frog dies in the walls of Black Edelweiss. So there's the first one. We need the second and the third.
This should be enough to avoid unwanted attention, at least from a distance.
Where did we put the man? Did we put him in the closet? In the... I think we put him in the container. Now we got the nurse disguise. Okay. What do we got here? We got the sedative.
Manufactured and packaged here.
Mm-hmm.
This is the same narcotic substance that
or
we
narcotic,
found in
not sedative. It's not really a sedative. What is this? Letter to Mr. Schnitzer. Herr Schnitzer, I hasten to assure you that your son is in good hands, that his unexpected development of a psychological disorder can be remedied at our facility. I am sure you are as concerned about your son's well-being as I am, and I am confident our combined efforts will lead to a speedy recovery. The housing of our pharmaceuticals in your warehouse is an important part of this process. If you succeed at drawing officials' attention away from this precious cargo, there will be nothing to stop me from returning your son to you, safe, sound, and free of this unfortunate illness. Yours sincerely, Professor Gygax. Yeah, that's not happening. He won't be fine. I'll say that. Is there anything else to look at before I go up? I don't think there is. So let us go. Or not go up, but in. But now we can actually walk about a bit. Got orderlies. Okay, wants me to do it.
Go away, or I will tear your lips from your skull with my fingernails!
Ah, yes.
Miss, I...
I'll gouge your eyes out and cut off your hands, just like you did to Heidi.
I am quite certain you would, but I'm afraid you have me mistaken for someone else.
Yes.
So, I take it your name is Gerda. Who is Heidi?
You talk strange. You're going to Hell's Door, aren't you? To where those other funny talkers finally shut up?
Hell's Door?
Yes,
to
Hell's
what do
Door.
What do you refer?
Only Heidi had answers. Go away, pig!
I merely...
I said go, or you will spend your last moments on Earth screaming. This door won't stop me.
Oh. I think it will. Heidi. All Gerda could talk about is Heidi. Heidi went through unimaginable torture. Her eyes and arms were torn off. Gerda's testimony. There's a patient named Gerda in one of the cells of Block B, and it sounds like she's been here for quite some time. Gerda didn't say much about the foreigners at the asylum, but she mentioned a place where those other funny talkers finally shut up. She said it's behind Hell's Door. Whatever that is, Gerda could know more. Yes, we are looking for Heidi.
They took you away, and I'll never forgive them.
Yes. Well, let us go find Heidi, which, if nobody watched the demo, you'll see exactly who she is. Investigation scene found. Yes. Laundry. Also, we got something here. Third little frog. Frogs cannot dream, and I surely can. That is the difference between a frog and a man. Frog's dreaming is seedless, there is nothing to reap, so I woke the third frog from his meaningless sleep. A man counts sheep, and Peter has seen Zero in Holden Chamber lie smothered by pillow. Third little frog dies in the walls of Black Edelweiss. So that's the third one. Where is the second? Restricted area. Let's go look at the laundry. Oh, yep, there she is.
The garments of several dozen people at least.
Before we pick up Heidi.
Fabric burnt in the furnace.
Who is a doll?
A jalabia, a traditional garment from Northern Africa.
Hi.
So you're Heidi. I didn't realize I was on haunted doll watch.
Yes, we are, Sherlock.
Good lord, how unsettling. The damage seems intentional.
Heidi. There was a doll named Heidi in the laundry room. It's in a horrible state. Yep, we're gonna bring her back to her. What? Let's go down this way. Shall we? Yes, I remember all this. Got here. Medical evaluations N4, young adult, male, nationality is Dutch. Diagnosis, a weak-minded subject eager to follow orders for perceived rewards. Strong build, dose with 0.4 milligrams. N5, male, adult, Romanian. The subject remained violent, requiring the need for traditional sedatives. Once calmed, the dosage for the subject was minimal, 0.2. N6, young adult male. Anu? Language incomprehensible. Subject is thus assumed mad. Subject possesses a lighter, more agile frame, and as such, a smaller dosage was required, 0.2. And N7, young adult male, Mori. Language incomprehensible, subject is thus assumed mad. Just because you don't understand the language does not mean they're mad. Subject was large and required an above average dosage, 0.8 milligrams. Was N7... Was that, Kimahia? Summary. All subjects in good condition, showing signs of obedience regardless of race or native language. They must move on for further testing. I have a feeling that might have been Kimihia.
So this is how they kept the prisoners docile and harmless.
Yep. That is exactly how they did it. I know there's stuff that we can look at here. I don't really want to do it just yet. Second little frog. Here we go. Frogs cannot choose, and I surely can. That is the difference between a frog and a man. Second little frog gave up to its fate, which I chose for her and served on a plate. Abigail Amraziel, bleeding almost full tank near the examination room, she lies with a shank. Second little frog dies in the walls of Black Edelweiss. There we go, we have all of them now. So now we can actually start from the very beginning. First little frog. So near a hole in the wall wanders there her head with a brick encounters. I did sort of see a pile of blood, but I didn't really know what it was about. Let's look at this. Dried bloody handprint, left hand.
The murderer used his left hand to kill Hannah with a brick.
Multiple murders, murderer's profile. Left-handedness. Okay, what about second little frog? Near the examination room. So we're going near, so examination room. So back to the examination room I go. Which was up here. Haha, here we go. Dry bloody boot prints limping on the right leg.
The killer was limping, but Abigail couldn't escape.
A limp favoring his right leg. So, third little frog, and count sheep, holding chamber lies smothered by pillow. Holding chamber. Back this way? Aha, here we go. Scratches on the walls. Nail scratches, blood traces, scratch marks, killer's blood.
Odds are he left scars on the killer, too.
That is... very likely. A scar on his face or neck. So now we go with fourth little frog. Swims in a bath, laundry. The bathtub in the laundry room, I remember, yes. I did see it, so let's head there. This way? Was it this way? Yes. Trying to get there quicker. Let's see. Hot water about 3 feet deep.
The killer was strong enough and the bathtub deep enough to drown poor Lucy.
Physically strong. Yep. And now the fifth little frog. Lies dead in block B. I swapped out his pills for something nasty. Block B. Also, I'm getting bonus stuff. What do we have in terms of, like, bonuses? Royal Garments, I think we got that in the last episode. Dr. H. West kit, medical kit to, well, reanimate the dead. Okay. And a sailor uniform. Nice. Okay, swapped his... Block B swapped out his pills for something nasty. Block B. Is that where we are? Where are we? We're in block A, so we need to head back to block. Or no, wait a minute, we are in block B. So, aha, here we go. Bitter almond smell empty.
The killer swapped Timothy's pills for cyanide. The faint almond scent is unmistakable. Well, it's clear that it was a multiple murderer. I'll send the profile to the police after we finish here.
Multiple murderer's profile. The subject feels superior to other humans and asserts himself at the expense of his victims. He calls them little frogs, likely seeing himself as a kind of scientist who prepares his subjects. Odds are he is meticulous, taking a long time to plan and prepare for each murder. Judging by the location of the crime scenes, the killer is or was an employee of the Black Edelweiss. Frogs in the Wall is finished. There was a series of murders in the Black Edelweiss. The killer has distinctive features. A limp favor in his right leg, a left-handedness, a scar on his face or neck, physically strong, a knowledge of medicines. Yep. Okay, so the frogs in the walls. That feels like a reference to the rats in the walls. Another Lovecraft story. Investigating the Edelweiss. Okay, let's give Heidi to Gerda.
I will make them pay for what they did to Heidi.
I found Heidi.
I believe I have found your friend.
Yes.
Heidi! Oh, poor girl. What did they do to you? Shh. It's all right now. Everything will be all right.
Please, Gerda, now I have found Heidi, I need some help from you in return.
Shh, Heidi. We should thank the man, don't you think?
Do you know... Why are you here?
How did you end up in Block B?
The nurses say I'm prone to violent outbursts, but they're wrong. I just do what Heidi tells me.
That's worrisome.
Have you ever met Professor Becker?
I remember him. He was in charge here before that witch Gygax. But I haven't heard his voice for a long time. Too bad. He was nice.
What do you know about
Professor
Gygax?
Gygax seems to rule this facility with an iron fist. Do you know anything about her?
She's sick. She did nasty things to us. Separated me and Heidi just for fun. Before she got here, this place was all right.
What happened to the foreign patients?
Tell me all you know about those funny talking people.
We'd hear their screams. The guards would take them down the corridor behind you and they'd disappear. And the screams would stop.
Okay.
I shall leave you two to get reacquainted.
Okay. Gerda got her doll back. Yeah. Okay. So now I do know what we do. We go this way to the restricted area because we got an investigation to do. Because we got some things we can actually look at here. So blood hit from above. Discoloration, strong chlorine.
This
smell.
Stretcher was disinfected frequently.
So let us look for things.
The doors can be opened for deliveries.
Yep.
These are the same crates we found in London.
Here we go.
We should take a closer look.
Yes, we should. Let us take a closer look. Oh, what we got here? Scratches. Scratches, broken nails. Yep.
Substantial blood loss. One poor soul found another way out.
Now, where was that? Ah, broken bottle. There we go.
A bottle this sturdy doesn't break by accident.
There we go. That's what I was looking for. Okay, so that's still up there. Let's look at this one. Black Edelweiss Secrets. We got another bottle.
I doubt that one could survive such a journey with this little water.
Oh.
Dirt and sweat. They were locked in here for days, judging by the smell.
Yep. There was air, though.
The kidnappers even provided airflow. How generous.
Just not enough, though. They were like... I mean, I could imagine how much they were sweating.
This is the same design as the one from London.
Yep.
This trip was prolonged and perilous.
Okay. An array of wooden crates are stored in Block B. They bear a striking resemblance to the ones found in London. Yes, they do. Yep, here we go. Scribbled in Georgian. Black Edelweiss Secrets. The abducted foreigners were kept in cells. They might already be gone, but the traces they left leave no doubt that they were here. Oh, we got this something sticking out. It's a cross.
An Orthodox reliquary commonly found in Eastern Europe, now in a cell halfway up the Alps.
Is there anything else? that we can find that we might miss. Because we don't want to miss anything. I don't want to miss anything. That's not it. That's not it. That's more likely. Yeah, one's dead, and then... There we go. That, no. That's more likely. Did I do this right? Yep,
okay. The carriages were back through these doors, and they began to unload their cargo in secret.
Mm-hmm.
Next, the crates were opened, freeing their passengers. Not everyone survived the journey.
Nope.
The dirty, exhausted, and dehydrated prisoners were then herded into cells. But all the cells are now empty, and I have not located a morgue. Time to find Hell's Door.
Yes, it is. Oh, what do we got here?
The stamp on this crate confirms it came from America. That's quite a distance to travel.
Yes, it is. The foreigners must be taken through a hidden door after some preparation in the cells. This passage must lie somewhere near the back entrance. Oh, what do we got here? Welded shut. No, that's not it. That can't be it. Is there anything else we can look at here that we might have missed? No, no, it doesn't seem like it. I know where it is, because I remember all this from the demo. Scratches.
Scratches. Something has been moved through here.
Yep. Round indent smells of machine oil.
This seems to be a locking mechanism. The whole thing must be a door.
There must be a secret passage somewhere near the rear entrance. The scratches on the floor near the wall seem like more than mere decoration. There's an indent in the wall. It is definitely a keyhole, yet lockpicks have proven useless. How to get the key to Hell's Door. So we can talk to Heidi. So how to get the key to Hell's Door. Oh, Gerda. Heidi. How to open Hell's Door.
I found Hell's Door, the one that made the foreigners silent, remember? How do I open it? Gerda, please. I cannot get inside. You have to tell me how to open it.
How can you speak to me like nothing's wrong?
Oh, boy.
Can't you hear Heidi crying? Look at her!
No,
look!
I cannot.
She's suffering. I can't even hear my thoughts over her screams. Poor, poor Heidi. We will fix you. I promise. We will fix you.
Me, Gerda.
Okay. Yep. Gerda got her doll back. She continues to maintain that only Heidi knows everything. There won't be any answers until she is repaired. That will require two buttons, thread, glue, and nails. Okay. Investigation scene found. Wait, investigation scene's been found. Where? Go to block A. Oh yeah, I do remember we get some of our stuff from all over the place. Yep, I remember. It's been a while since we last played the demo. Oh yeah, we did look at that earlier. Okay, here we go. We got some nails, slightly rusted nails. Let's pick those up. Construction adhesive. Let's take that. Investigation scene complete. Oh. I found the glue, I found the nails. Now we just need thread and two buttons. So let's go find some thread along with two buttons. Here we go. Okay, loose buttons. Yes, please. And then a long thread. We shall take. Everything is ready for Heidi's repair. I gathered some buttons, I have enough threads. Okay, let us fix Heidi. Oof. I'm gonna regret this.
Will this help fix your friend?
Give it to me.
Here you go.
How is she feeling?
Everything will be all right, Heidi. Everything.
Goethe, I have a couple of questions.
Yes, I...
You dirty little mouth, Goethe. You've said enough already. She won't speak no more. Now it's only Heidi. You helped me, and I didn't cut out your eyes. So we're even.
Oh! Oh, okay.
Heidi, there are things I need some clarity on.
Ask if you dare, but if I get bored, there will be consequences.
Okay. Let's be careful about this. So not that, not that. So that does that.
I found Hell's Door, but it's locked. Is there a way to get in?
Hell's Door? Never heard of it.
That's a lie, because Goethe told us.
That's not true. You, Goethe, told me that Hell's Door makes people silent forever.
And you believe that snotty little girl? I'll personally ensure that she
never dares to speak again!
Stop it. What about a note from Professor Becker? Yes.
Professor Gygax hurt you repeatedly, scarred your body and mind. You are not protecting Hell's Door. You are simply afraid of the consequences were I to enter.
Mm-hmm. I could tap your teeth out with a hammer until you choked on the blood in bits.
Lovely.
You could, but then you would live the rest of your life in fear of Professor Gygax. I can make that feeling go away.
How?
I can stop her. But the key, Heidi, the key to Hell's Door is critical to stopping Professor Gygax. And I think you know where it is.
Tell him!
But you said...
And now I say tell him!
The professor, she has a special key. Keeps it close and only brings it down when new people go through. Behind those closed doors, those people start to sing. Well, they sing in so much pain.
Gygax, of course. Thank you, Goethe. Heidi, I must leave.
Yep.
Leave? You joke. Nobody leaves the Edelweiss. Now you will be with us forever!
That's where the demo ended. Okay, now we're doing what I haven't seen yet. So Heidi said that Professor Gygax is the only person capable of opening Hell's Door. She must have a key in her office. Yep. How to get the key to Hell's Door. Okay, so let's see. I mean, Watson, I think, is gonna help. Dumbwaiter, possibly. The dumbwaiter would. Heidi's testimony about Hell's Door. Is that possible? Yes. Watson could find it and send it downstairs. Seeking help from Watson. Watson must be in the guest room that is beside Gygax's office. Perhaps he could acquire the key and use the kitchen dumbwaiter to deliver it down to the storage room. There we go. How to get Watson to help. Thinking about this, I want to unpin that. Maybe the patient that hates the guards, Maurizio, who thinks he's Napoleon Bonaparte, in the block path. Is that it? It is. Use the patient to create a diversion. The patient who claims to be Napoleon Bonaparte could help. Freeing him could create enough of a distraction to find and contact Watson on the ground floor. Absolutely. That could absolutely help. So let's go talk to Maurizio. And see if he can help us. I heard what sounded like screams. I don't know if any of y'all heard that. Nope, this way, not that way. Wrong way. Maurizio! Oh. Oh, we're letting him out. Okay, what does that do? So that third one is unlocked. So we don't change that. We're just testing. So that one is unlocked now, and that one is. So the second, the fourth, and the sixth one we need to do more with. Second, fourth, and sixth one. Now the last one, just like that. And there we go. Lock, stock, and barrel. Achievement unlocked. You cannot return after leaving. Be sure to finish everything you wanted to do here. Okay, I mean, I think we've done everything we can do here. We found everything, I'm pretty sure. So let's go forward. Oh god, game. Let us go forwards. Yep.
At last, you came to your senses.
Yes.
My humble apologies, Emperor. Spare me your groveling, Englishman.
Okay.
Of course, you are right as ever, for you see, time is of the essence. The Royalists have risen again, and your darling Josephine needs you. Paris needs you.
Mon amour.
But the guards upstairs in reception stand in your way.
Ha! They will pose no problem for the likes of me. Merci, Englishman. When I return to Les Tuileries, I shall make you a general.
Oh, you are too kind, Emperor. Now go. Your freedom awaits.
I am coming, Josephine.
Oh my god.
Catch him!
Oh boy. We've done it.
Psst. Watson. Over here.
Hello.
Holmes, what are you doing here, and where did you get that outfit?
Don't mind that.
Unimportant. I require your assistance.
You hid your plant. Tell me what's going on.
What is happening, Holmes? I need an explanation.
It's quite simple. I created a distraction so that I could tell you something important, and in turn, I need you to acquire something important for me.
How can you call any of this charade simple?
Watson, we can discuss this later. Time is of the utmost importance. The kidnapped people may still be here. This is what I know so far.
What? You really found all this on your own?
Focus, Watson. I need you to find a key. It will be most unique. All the details are in my notes. Logic dictates that Gygax will keep it near her. Once acquired, you must get it to me. Perhaps the kitchen dumbwaiter could be of use.
Holmes, I can't do this. I'm no spy.
Yes, you can, Watson. You are unfailingly dependable.
Dr. Watson? Visitors are not permitted back here.
Sorry
I'm
about that.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. Kuntz. After the war, my nerves, I fled all that commotion.
It is nothing. A patient attempted to escape. He will not get far.
Okay.
Now, if you would like to follow me.
Sure thing, I can absolutely do that. And now we're playing as Watson. Again. Okay. Yeah, none of this was in the demo, so I have no idea what's going on from here. It's great. You must acquire a key for me, Watson. Odds are it's a round item about 2 inches in diameter with the image of an Edelweiss flower. A patient named Gerda has informed me that Gygax will keep it close. I suggest investigating her office. Yes. Block A wait, why is that one? Sherlock's note.
Blood in the water. Someone must have washed their hands here recently.
Lovely.
What have we got ourselves into, Holmes?
Something, that's for sure.
The only reason to hang something this harrowing here would be to create another patient.
Yeah, that's true. Can we look at that painting? No, we cannot. We do have something to look at here, though. Oh, a gun. Oh, it's a revolver.
Perhaps I should take this. For all I hope it won't be needed.
Yeah, let's take it, because we might... There's no telling if we will need it.
Did a child make these?
Heidi! Oh! Gerda, I'm assuming, made that. But more likely Heidi. Okay. Don't tell me we have to sneak about, because I don't want to sneak about. Guest room. director's office. Okay, that's where we need to go. The kitchen. Okay. We got the dumbwaiter.
It's dusty but functional.
Yep. That's what we're gonna use.
Oh, we never use that. I think it connects somewhere downstairs.
Thank you for that information.
Did you hear that a patient escaped? All the guards rushed off to find him?
Yes, I did hear about it.
I suppose it will be one less ungrateful mouth to feed if he dies out there.
Is that brown, brown, back? Or
one
black
time,
sheep,
it took them
whatever
five
it's called.
Days to find a patient. They found him frozen in the snow.
Gee, have you any wool? Yes,
right
sir.
Off.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I forgot the name of the song. I don't know why. Patient room 2. Okay. What do we got out here? Hello.
I don't want to guard block B tonight.
Why is that?
Did you see my son? He's such a sweet boy. If you happen to meet him, tell him I'm here.
Okay, will do.
Give it to me.
No, I don't want to.
Why not?
You're mean.
That's rude. And I'm not. You're lying.
Minor birds, if I'm not mistaken. Beautiful creatures. How sad that they're caged here.
It's very sad.
A visitor? No, no, you shouldn't have come here.
Why is that?
Get out while you can.
Well, actually, I don't need to ask why is that, because I think we already know.
Miss?
Too bad my parents had to leave so soon. I haven't seen them for months.
Yeah.
I hear them scratching. Don't you hear it?
No.
The nurses don't believe me. No one helps me.
Ugh. Hello.
I want them to fly. Try to fly away. Escape, my little ones.
If they could, they would. Hello.
This area is off limits. A patient has escaped.
Okay. Patient room number 2.
I'm struggling to remember something.
Okay. Patient's poetry. Oh, beautiful alpine flower whose heart I do miss so. You called to me while I don't see. How could I let you go? The storm cuts through my senses, makes all my thoughts so blind. With no captain, I misreason. What did they truly find? Cold and dark with grimy walls, roughly held like animals. Trapped yet free, why do I fall? Something squirms on the tip of the tongue, but what can it be? What did I forget?
It's something familiar. If only I could place it. I must sink.
Okay. Let's just leave that room. That was the kitchen. We've already been in there. What about the director's office?
Ah, Dr. Watson.
Hello.
Just the man I wanted to see.
Professor, I'm surprised you're not trying to catch that escapee.
Please, my time is far too valuable. I hope Nurse Kuntz has been taking good care of you.
He has certainly kept me out of trouble.
Professor, it is time for your appointment with your next patient, Mr. Wolf.
Wolf can wait until tomorrow. I wish to speak with Dr. Watson.
Okay.
As you wish.
You still see patients yourself, even as the director of this entire facility?
Only the important ones. And yet I rarely get to pick the brain of a man like yourself. I think it is time we got to know each other, no?
I'm afraid there's not much to know. I'm just an average chap living a rather prosaic life these days.
Dr. Watson, those of us who pursue knowledge are anything but average. Now, who are you?
Well, I'm all three of these things, but
I'm a physician in search of a stimulating career. I have patients, yes, but admittedly, I'm more interested in the cutting edge of medical research. So when I read about the Black Edelweiss and your work on the healing of minds, I simply had to learn more.
I suppose my Edelweiss was always destined to attract other curious minds. But before we continue, I want you to understand one thing. A broken mind can never be truly healed.
Ah, I see. So, what exactly do you do here?
It is simple. If you cannot fix a person's nature, you must force them to forget it.
Surely there are other methods of treatment.
How naive. You remind me of a man I once knew, Professor Becker. But we do not speak of him anymore.
A colleague?
The former director here. One day he realized that Edelweiss had outgrown him and had to leave. Already, Doctor?
No, sorry. Just admiring the office.
I was simply admiring your office, Professor. Apologies.
While I am pleased you appreciate its practicality and appearance, we were discussing bigger things.
Yes, yes.
Was my conversation boring you?
No, not at all. I merely...
No. I understand full well. You're not seeking conversation.
What do you mean?
It is obvious. Your mind craves truth, but not in this form. You must witness a practical demonstration if you are to learn.
I'm certainly intrigued. Okay. Would that be possible?
Of course. I propose a journey between the jury of the human brain. You will not leave without being truly enlightened. Kunz, take Dr. Watson back to the courtyard. Then tell the nurses to prepare the operation room and the girl with the doll.
Yes, Professor.
Our preparations will take...
Did I go with the right options?
I will come for you soon, Doctor.
Okay. See, very important patient. Wolf is an important patient to Professor Gygax. I think we know where he is. Professor Gygax is the current director of the Black Edelweiss. She seems to disapprove of the previous director, Professor Becker, and clearly believes herself to be intellectually superior. Despite being a director, she's still treating patients, if only the important ones. A patient called Wolf is among them. Gygax does not intend to leave her office anytime soon. How to lure Gygax out of her office, and why does Gygax care about Wolf? Let's go talk to... I think we know where Wolf is. He's in here.
Maybe if I write another poem, I will remember.
Or maybe not.
When people shout, all I want to do is find a dark corner and hide. I can't bear it.
I just want the scratching to stop.
Is it you?
Shh, stranger.
We must be quiet.
Yes.
If you linger too long, the professor will keep you forever.
Thank you for that. Guest room. What is this way? I don't think we actually went this way. We didn't go this way. This is... Yeah, this we've all seen... Yeah, we can't go that way. We can't go to the examination room.
I can't just leave Holmes here alone.
No, we cannot.
I hope you're finding your room comfortable, Dr. Watson.
It's a nice room. It's not a bad room. What do we got here? Administration. Ooh, what do we got here? Gygax's patient reports, October 1879. As more serious treatment is necessary, my special patient Wolf will be transferred to patient room 2 on the ground floor. That's what I thought. All other patients must be removed from my schedule and reassigned to other specialists at the Institute. This patient's mental state requires constant monitoring and immediate intervention to avoid undesirable consequences. December 1879, the necessary surgical procedures were successfully performed. Physical recovery is still in progress. Memory loss is increasing, but still not complete. A new obsession with writing has developed, probably has a side effect. As a side effect. And then January of the next year, the patient's writing now mentions old names. Clear sign of partial memory recovery. Unacceptable. Unacceptable results. A second surgery is required, targeting both the frontal and temporal lobes. And then February, surgery went well. The patient's memory does not persist for longer than a couple of minutes, although an obsession with writing lingers. Danger eliminated, daily monitoring prescribed. Yep. What do we got here?
Good Lord, that's a lot of records.
That is a lot. We don't really have all day to be going through all of it. What we got here?
Photograph seems recent. A commemorative photo album. Been a while since I've been in one of these.
A recent photograph labeled Professor Gygax and the Black Edelweiss staff, 1879. So there's nothing else we can look at in the room. No, there isn't. Okay. Now we head to patient room 2, because now we have the information that we need in order to speak with Wolf, I think.
You are Mr. Wolf, am I right?
Oh, hello. Who might you be?
My name is Dr. John Watson. I wanted to talk with you, if you didn't mind.
Ah, doctor. I don't suppose you could help. I seem to have forgotten where I am.
We're in the Black Edelweiss, Mr. Wolf. It's an asylum in Switzerland, and you're one of its most important patients.
But why am I here?
That's what I was about to ask you.
I can't remember. Sorry, I can't remember anything.
It's all right, you don't need to push. Try to relax. Let the thoughts come and go. Now, what comes to mind?
If anything.
Mr. Wolf?
Hello? Who might you be?
We just went over this.
I'm sorry, but I don't think we've met.
We were just discussing this facility, the Black Edelweiss Asylum, and why you are here.
That name does sound familiar.
Holmes, the things I do.
Excuse me, who are you? And who's this Holmes fellow?
I am Dr. Watson, and Holmes is, well, you could call him my imaginary friend. That's just a little joke, don't mind me.
Why am I here, doctor? Am I sick?
I'm sure I can take a look.
Okay, so he has memory loss. Like, real short-term memory loss. Two deep scars, precise surgical incisions. Facial palsy, one side is paralyzed. Okay. Yep. Severe chemical burns, faded with age. Anything down here? Oh, yep. Skin pigmentation, possible abuse of medicine. Ill and treatment isn't working, or ill due to treatment itself. Let's see, an adult male with two deep surgical scars on the side of his head and an old chemical burn on one of his hands. Mr. Wolf has some paralysis of facial muscles and blue-gray pigmentation spots on his skin. These symptoms are most likely pre-existing in his admission to the Black Edelweiss for treatment. So far failed to cure him. Or ill due to treatment. I think it's due to treatment. It appears that his illness is a direct result of the treatment he has received here at the Black Edelweiss. The skin are likely due to the overuse of medications containing silver nitrate. I think it's ill due to treatment.
Dear Lord, what did Gygax do to you?
I don't think we want to know.
Who are you?
Oh, God. Never mind.
Okay. Yep. Okay, so why does Gygax care about Wolf? So we need one item, one observation, one document, and testimony. I mean, the only... we don't have much. Okay.
Excuse me, who are you?
Okay. I don't know why I keep doing this, except it's something different.
I don't know why either, to be quite honest with you. Well, that's the only thing we got there. OK, character portrait, and then potentially... Not Gerda's testimony. What about... would it be her testimony? Or would it be the patient report? What about the patient reports? There we go. Wolf is the former director. Oh! Wolf is actually Professor Becker, the previous director of the Black Edelweiss. He did look familiar. He now suffers from severe memory issues, but still retains the ability to write. Yep. Wolf is actually... And now how do we get her out? Very important patient. Patient report. Let's think about... So, her testimony. There we go. Use Becker to distract Gygax. If Becker can still write, perhaps he can get Gygax's attention with a letter. I think so. Becker can still write, perhaps he can get Gygax's attention. Yep, let us do that. Let's go talk to Becker. Not Wolf, Becker. This is the guest room. This is the wrong side. I was already on the right side. Hello.
Hello again. You won't remember me, but we've met before. I am Dr. John Watson, and you are Professor Becker. You were the previous director of this facility, the Black Edelweiss.
Professor, really? Actually, that name does sound familiar. Wait. Let me write it down. I try to recall memories through writing, but they always feel just out of reach.
As a matter of fact, I have more for you to jot down.
Oh, yes. Yes, please, anything.
Professor Gygax did this to you. She made you forget everything, even who you are. But we will play a trick on her. Mm-hmm. We will write a letter so that she learns her lesson. Put down what I dictate.
Gygax is cruel, or Gygax is a poor director?
Dear Professor Gygax,
she does feel very intellectually superior.
Fall under your influence. I see now that you never deserved to sit as the director of the Black Edelweiss. You are not, as you so claimed, the future of the Edelweiss, and you
that would get to her.
And by the time you make it to my cell, the police will already know the truth of how you came to be director of this asylum. Signed, Professor Becker.
There. It's done. Now, hold on a minute. Who are you?
My name is John Watson. I'm a doctor from London, a veteran of Afghanistan, and I wish to be a writer, though deep down I fear I lack the talent. And presently I'm risking my life to help my brilliant detective flatmate in the pursuit of a cult of kidnappers, even as I fear it may destroy him. I'm tired and hungry, and I have not had a good bath in weeks, and yet despite it all, I...
Oh, God.
I feel alive. Any more questions?
Good heavens, sir. You're as mad as they come.
Yeah, no. Yep, all that. Now we can talk to someone. Do we talk to Gygax? Or do we hand the letter
One
over?
Of the patients
we hand the letter
over. This note
Aha.
That's for Professor Gygax.
Thank you, Doctor. Leave it with me.
Will do. She is not gonna like this.
Unbelievable. Kunz, with me.
There we go. Okay. So now we can actually go into her office and do some examination, shall we?
Nothing special about this.
Are you sure? Oh, really? There is actually nothing special? Oh. Okay. Nothing special, I guess. Is that the only thing we have to look at on the desk? Oh no, we got several things, actually. Yeah, this right off the bat. A letter opener?
Close, but I don't think this is the key. This is too small to be what Holmes asked for.
Yeah. What do we got here? Oh. Letter from New Orleans Bank. Dear Professor, we recently took possession of a collection of rare gems on behalf of a mutual acquaintance. The gems have now been sold to Louisiana jewelers, who made several offers far exceeding our experts' estimate of the stone's value. The final sale price agreed upon for the 11 gems was 12,550 Swiss francs. Our client has instructed that you receive 2/3 of the sum transferred to your solicitor as per usual. As always, our discretion is assured, and we look forward to continued business with you and your illustrious patron. Yours sincerely, Jeffrey Scott, representative of the E.W. Gray Banking House, New Orleans, USA, January the 9th, 1882. Before I pick that up, anything of interest here? Anything? Oh, wait. What do we got here? A diary. Really? That's not of interest? Gygax's diary, December 1879. It has been 3 months since I took over the Edelweiss from Becker. Not all my colleagues approved of the rule changes, so I am now the only professor here. No matter, the hiring of several strong nurses will solve the personnel shortage. At last, my work can flourish without the impairment of his lesser mind. Then March. The first payment has arrived from R. Our deal does pose risks, but the possibilities are endless if he is true to his word. And then May. The first shipment of Chosen Ones has arrived. R has sent a vast selection of broken minds. The work ahead will be difficult, but undoubtedly useful for their own research, for my own research as well. Two birds with one stone. Interesting. Okay, now let's look at this, because this might actually be it.
An Edelweiss relief about 2 inches in diameter.
Yep.
This must be what Holmes was after.
It has to be. A special key. We probably should not leave those open, in all honesty, but we're going to. That's not good. Okay. We have what we need. So a metallic key designed to look like a seal stamp with a relief of an Edelweiss flower. It's 2 inches in diameter intended to be inconspicuous. We have to use the dumbwaiter. Oh, yep, no one's in here, so now we can actually put it in the dumbwaiter. So this scene looks really dark. Why is it so dark? Hello. Ooh. What's up? What have we done? Black Edelweiss secrets. An array. Yeah, okay.
It's sealed tight. I can't exit the same way.
Nope. Okay. Let's see, what do we have here? Broken tooth, light-colored enamel.
The tooth of an adult male, likely lost in a beating. Only a couple of days old.
Ugh. And there's chain, steel chain and worn.
The inside of the cuff is worn. It's been used often.
Yep. What do we got here?
A wax cylinder. There is something recorded on it.
Ooh. Okay.
The writing is mostly gone. Phonetic symbols, perhaps.
Possibly. Someone's messaging me. No, I thought someone was messaging me. I guess not. Phonograph. cylinder from some sort of classroom in the lower basement. It holds an audio recording. Yep, so we're going to have to listen to that. The sub-basement contains a classroom where people were handcuffed to chairs. The blackboard in the sub-basement classroom was white, but it's still possible to make out some symbols on it. They appear to form some sort of phonetic transcription. Ugh. I don't like this. I really don't like this. I'm not gonna go that way just yet. Yeah, I'm gonna go this way first. Oh god. It's an elevator? Notebook of Professor Gygax. Oh, achievement unlocked. History check. Oh god, my head also. Ow. Ah. The new method at last started to show progress. The success rate is 4 out of 10, and the failures are not responding to any external stimuli. Nevertheless, the phonetic system can be declared an undeniable success, regardless of their native language or place of origin. Individuals learn to speak the chant without flaw. They learn it quickly and fluently, despite lacking all mental autonomy. Regrettably, one of the chosen continues to resist. Isolation and deprivation resulted in a strengthening of their disobedience. Negotiation only ignited anger, and even after the direct removal of the frontal and temporal lobes, it seems all that was left was an innate desire to resist. This chosen one cannot be allowed to pollute the minds of the others. The conclusion is inescapable. They cannot continue to live. I will see to it they are sent to the well. The well? I do think I saw the well.
Looks as if it's been recently used.
Okay. The sub-basement has a functioning phonograph. It is able to play wax cylinders. What do we got on the desk? Got a brain in the jar, I see that. Handwritten letter. Professor, trust my guide, the light of the abyss, for he shall enlighten our chosen ones. Make sure he is present in that our chosen utter nothing but the sacred words. And lo, the trance will begin and we will be an inch closer to the universe beyond. Your work is essential, as many of our flock do not speak our language and time is of the essence. It would be best to work in groups, performing at least one seance per day for a week. Of course, the most skeptical members will have to be tamed by your hands. In the meantime, my work continues on a physical method to maintain the trance state through the emitted light waves of Kaleid lenses. Finally, my men in New Orleans will contact you regarding the new shipment of Chosen. Make room for them as you have done before. R. Who is this R person? What do we got here? A telegram from New Orleans. The bank has the gems. My master has ordered me to send the first shipment of chosen ones. They will arrive within 2 weeks. Do not fail us. A. We do have a key. There we go. Shiny key. A key found on Professor Gygax's desk in the sub-basement. And the telegram and the handwritten note. Oh. Okay. I think the key went to that door. One of the rooms in the sub-basement is dedicated to surgical procedures. Yep.
Dynamo machine. Provides electrical stimulation for the person in the chair.
Yeah.
Full grain leather straps, impossible to escape.
Black Edelweiss secrets. We're learning more and more about this place. This is not pleasant. The chairs use strapped in the patients for medical procedures. At the base of the chair is a dynamo generator that could provide electric shocks to stimulate the patients. Oh, I am not going down there.
A very professional brain dissection.
Mm. Dissecting the brains of the birds. Mina bird has been meticulously dissected in the sub-basement. The bird's brain is exposed. Before I go there...
The spell.
What do we got here? This must smell really, really bad.
Judging by the remnants of blood and flesh, these instruments were used for dismemberment.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Dear God, is that body parts? Utterly inhuman.
Yeah. Gaze into the abyss. This is awful. Let's just go. There's a bloody well in the sub-basement of the asylum. Many tools for dismemberment are lying around the well, covered in dried blood. Yep. Okay.
Ring Glue Maglana Park Tulu. Rilie Wagnana Garpet Hagen. Ring Glue Maglana Park Tulu. Rilie Wagana Garpet Hagen. Ring Glue Maglana Park Tulu. Rilie Wagana Garpet Hagen. Ring Glue Maglana Park Tulu. Rilie Wagana Garpet Hagen.
Okay, let's leave all that.
Get out of my head!
Your arm twisted, void of soul. Find reverence for the one that trembles.
Great Lord!
Surrender your soul and become a servant of madness!
Please! No more! Stop it! Watson! John! Somebody!
What the hell is going on? I didn't use the key!
Awaken! And let the
world behold!
The light of the abyss is the light from the abyss. Get out of my head.
One of the cylinders bears a recording of a chant in an unknown language. A bizarre man was being held in the sub-basement. He vanished without a trace, only left a pounding voice that repeats. The light of abyss. The man spoke about strange things and the coming of a great lord. Did I not get to use the key? Or did I use the key? Why is the elevator coming to that?
A hydraulic elevator? How ingenious.
Very ingenious. I don't think there's anything else I can do here, so let's go. Did I miss something?
Watson?
Holmes, what are you still doing here?
Still? I was trying to find more information. Did you think I was just going to sit in my room twiddling my thumbs?
I only asked you to find the key. I had everything else under control.
Says the man who looks like he saw a ghost.
Yeah.
I am fine, Watson.
No, you're not.
You're hardly fine. You reek of congealed blood and chemicals. What did you see down there?
Never mind me. Where's Gygax?
I'm afraid she's over there. I found her like that when I entered, on my word.
Oh!
What? She was our biggest lead.
Yet another wrinkle in our investigation. What do we do now, Holmes?
Hush. Let me think.
What do we do? She's dead. Oh, God.
I had nothing to do with this, Holmes. I swear it.
I believe you because I see the doll. Heidi.
Heidi, how did she... it end up here?
I think we know how. I think we know what happened. Or maybe we have some kind of idea.
The patients here wear the same robes.
I mean...
No traces of blood on her clothes. Must have got on her white overcoat.
She was a terrible person, so...
The pencil is buried deep all the way to the brain. Instant death.
We'd better inform the local police.
Oh, wait, Becker!
You're right, Watson. But first, we need to determine where our case goes next.
That is true. We need to figure out where it goes. Where does the evidence lead us? Okay, three observations. Okay. Maybe... You know, I'm thinking the handwritten letter. That's the only thing I can think of. Oh, New Orleans in the USA. Several pieces of evidence now point to New Orleans. It appears that the kidnappers have enlisted the services of the banking house of E.W. Gray to sell gems. Yep. So we're heading to New Orleans.
We've got what we needed, Watson. This conspiracy reaches further than we thought.
Yep.
Don't suppose you've ever been to New Orleans?
You are joking.
I seldom do.
I'm not.
Let's go. There's no time to waste.
We are not joking, sadly. A method to his madness.
There's nothing in this world that cannot be explained with logic and reason. Nothing in this world.
Are you sure?
Holmes? You seem troubled.
I'm not troubled, Watson. I am preoccupied.
That place was awful. Inhumane. It would be natural to experience some feelings of shock or fear.
Men reduced to gibbering imbeciles, numb beyond recognition, powerless to help themselves. When a doctor does go wrong, they are the first of criminals. They have the nerve and they have the knowledge.
That woman did not deserve the title. Such casual cruelty for such selfish aims.
I knew another man like that once. Treated my mother, perhaps even killed her, depending on who you ask.
No.
My sincere condolences.
In the end, she was just a shadow of herself. The outline of the person I recognized, but lacking all else, she was pushed until she cracked. Should you see me cracking, John?
Oh.
I must ask you to intervene.
Nothing compels us to pursue this matter further, Sherlock. We can return to London, report what we have discovered. Let more capable hands take over.
Alas, there are no such hands. Were we to abandon our quest now, I fear no other would succeed in our stead.
We know nothing of what awaits, what dangers lurk in the darkness.
Nonsense. We draw nearer to New Orleans with every passing minute, and thus closer to the answers we seek. Those answers, for all their perversity and improbability, will, nevertheless, be the work of men. And that is a work I have studied well.
So be it.
I know you to be a diligent author, but if I may make one request. Kindly omit my mother and her suffering from your tale.
Of course.
Oh.
Thank you, John.
Damn, poor Sherlock. Ooh. Chapter 4, The Outsiders. That is going to be the next video. New Orleans. That is going to be the next video. Oh, God.
Ah, Holmes. After our trip to Nippy, Switzerland, I can certainly use some of this New World heat.
Do not get carried away, Watson. What we could certainly use are answers to my questions.
I know, but you look exhausted. Why didn't we find the hotel first?
Sherlock,
we shall
does
rest
look
when our investigation is
well
over, and not a moment sooner. I shall ask you to handle our bags while I search for the bank.
As you wish. Oi!
Oh.
Stop it, you! Our luggage! Good Lord, what have you done? That's my stuff.
I'm sorry, mister. It was an accident.
Oh, boy. Okay, so we are going to do all of this in the next episode. That third chapter was something. I hope you all enjoyed this. If you did, please leave a thumbs up, comment down below. Once you've done that, please hit the subscribe button and that bell to stay notified whenever a new video has been uploaded. I hope everyone's doing well. I hope everyone's staying safe, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye-bye.